When you're shopping for bread or your favorite breakfast cereal at the grocery store, you don't have to wonder whether it'll be in stock. And that's because scientists and farmers are constantly working on maintaining a global wheat crop that's healthy, tasty, and tough against disease. But climate change is making that work more challenging. KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman explains.
Think of what you've eaten today. A bagel for breakfast, leftover pizza for lunch, or pasta plans for dinner. All of those foods and countless more are made with wheat. In fact, wheat counts for 20% of all of the calories consumed by humans worldwide.
It's important for humans because it's one of the cereals that has the highest protein content.
Making it nutritious.
And you can make bread.
And delicious. And the demand for wheat and wheat products is expected to skyrocket.
It's the simple math of having 30 billion more people in the next 20, 30 years. So we need to produce a lot more wheat than we are producing now.
Meeting that demand increase is enough of a challenge, but climate change is adding additional stress to the crops.
We have always have to fight for our food. What's different now is because the climate is changing faster than was changing before, the risk of frost is different than 10 years ago, the higher temperatures in the summer come earlier.
Then there's intensifying drought cycles, not just here in California, but in places like the Great Plains, which produce a substantial amount of the wheat consumed in the U.S. Currently, major droughts affect 15% of the world's wheat growing area within a year. Without dramatic carbon emissions cuts, 60% of that wheat growing area would be threatened by major droughts. That could cut annual wheat crop yields in half. Reducing emissions and breeding new wheat varieties faster will both be needed to avoid significant shortages. The team at UC Davis is part of a group of 40 wheat breeding programs working together with a $15 million grant from the USDA.
The idea is to make those breeding programs more efficient.
Your favorite bowl of cereal likely depends on it.
Right now, it takes about 10 years to develop a new breed of wheat and get it on the market. The goal of this collaborative project is to cut that time in half. With this week's Forecasting Our Future story, I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman for KCRA 3 News.